Yo, I am Martha from GynaCube, and in this video I want to talk to you about the solution that I was noticing was getting some attention at FabCon, and it's called FUAM. So it stands for Fabric Unified Admin Monitoring, and it's essentially a solution accelerator for fabric admin monitoring. So let's check it out. First of all, shout out to Gellert Gintley and Kevin Thomas for making this happen. We all know working with Fabric can be a bit challenging because there is so many items and so many workspaces and so many capacities, but this Fabric Unified Admin Monitoring solution is going to help you get all that information out of Fabric, provide you with that holistic view in a report. You can also dive into all the details. And the best part is, it's all built in Fabric. So that means that you can also customize the solution and change it up and add your own data if you want to. But you know what I like to do? Enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my laptop. Today, we're actually gonna start inside of GitHub and check out the Fabric Toolbox. The Fabric Toolbox is a toolbox essentially to give you accelerators and tools and scripts and stuff that you can utilize in your Fabric development. And one of those tools is the FUAM framework. So if you go into monitoring, you see that we have Fabric Unified Admin Monitoring. And this GitHub repository is going to tell you all the things you need to know about FUAM and how you can start using it. And that's, of course, what we're going to do together today. I have already created a FUAM workspace and have also created a service principle that I added to the security group inside the admin portal. And I gave that service principle access to some of the API features. So for instance, service principle can access read-only admin APIs. So I added my service principle to the security group right here. And I also added service principle can use Fabric APIs. I stored all the keys of that service principle in a key vault, and I also created a Fabric metrics app. So you have to do that as well, but all of this is described on the GitHub page, so just follow that and you will be fine. And inside my beautiful workspace, I also already downloaded the deploy FUAM notebook that you find in the GitHub repository by importing it just like this. Now I did one more preparation, and that was to set up the capacity metrics workspace, and I even renamed it to the FUAM capacity metrics workspace. And that is because we're gonna get some data from this capacity metrics workspace and pull that into this FUAM report that we're gonna end up with. So let's just go ahead and do the fun things. It says that we now need to run this notebook. So we're gonna open it up, and then very easily, we're just gonna click run all. Now, when everything has run smoothly, let's go back to the workspace and just take a look at all these things that now has been created for us, just like that. The next step is to now check out these connections that have been created for us. So let's open up Manage Connections and Gateways. And here you're going to see the FUAM Fabric Service API Admin and the FUAM Power BI Service API Admin. Now we want to edit these and use the service principle as the authentication, because this is going to be used as a connection for the pipelines that we're going to run that is actually connecting to the Fabric APIs. And then we do the same for this one as well. Now, if you have already created a new capacity metrics app, the next step is that we need to run a pipeline to actually pull all that data into our report for us to analyze and get all of that information. So that pipeline is load from data E2E. So we're going to open this one up, and then we want to click run. And as you see here on the side, there's a bunch of different parameters we have to fill in. And the description of each of these parameters you can find inside of the how to deploy FUAM. So you can dive into all those details and what you need to think about when you fill them out. And you see that some of them are default and some of them are optional. So for me now, I need to make sure that we are pulling in the correct workspace name for the capacity metrics workspace and also the data set that we have there. The key vault information is optional, so you don't have to pull in the key vault information. You can just keep it blank. And then when I'm ready, I'm gonna click run. And after a little while, you see that our pipeline has been running. We have all that data pulled in. Amazing. Now, the next step for us is to go back to the workspace and then take a look at the semantic models. And then we need to do some refreshing on these semantic models. So let's click refresh these ones. And now we're actually ready to take a look on the actual report. So the main report here is the FUAM core report. Finally, the big reveal, all the data that we have pulled in now, and now we can finally dig into the insights of our admin monitoring. Now, as you see here, this report is already created for us. We have this starting page here where you get the big overview. You can look at the tenant overview specifically if you want to. And you see here that we have data in GynaCube all over the world, actually. We can look at capacity information and all of those details. We can look at workspaces, item overview, tenant settings. We have activities. There's just a bunch of different things we could dive into and look at to better understand how Fabric works for us in our organization. Now, the final step would be to schedule the pipeline to run whenever I want it to run and make sure that it's updated when we need to. And of course, since this is just a Power BI report, you can now edit it and change it, add on new data. You can do what you need to make this report perfect for you and your organization. And now I want to know what you think about this. Did you know about the FUAM framework? Is this something you're going to try and test out? Let me know in the comments below. And of course, as always, check out all the amazing videos from Adam, Patrick, and myself. And we will see you guys in the next video.